all the time. Julio's been like hoping Kenzo exactly. level up his game and everything.
Exactly.
So this is like the last place Kenzo wanted to be.
Yeah, this is unfortunate, but sometimes it's got to happen. And when you're not a seeded player and you don't perform as well as some of the others, this kind of stuff happens.
The random seeding for the non-seeded players hurts.
And all it means at the end of the day, you got to step it up. But that's a good thing too. Unless it like this. Anyways, back to the match.
Oh, absolutely. It's so great because I watched them playing earlier, even though Julio was playing a Relento, actually. And, you know, just talking to Kenzo, be like, oh no, okay, this situation, use your red focus. No, hey, uppercut more. Like, hey, I like doing stuff on my defense. No. Get that player specific read.
Ultra. Hit. Should kill.
Such a good convert from Julio. Oh, wow. Wait, what do we expect from Julio? That's what he does.
Yeah, he maximizes every damage opportunity.
Mm-hmm. And when you play a character like Yun that can build his meter so fast, why not spend the meter? Oh, I get more damage? I'll use the meter.
You know the thing that's really great about Julio's game nowadays? Back then, he didn't create a lot of opportunities. He didn't have that skill. Nowadays, he plays a little bit more calculated. He's able to create more opportunity and maximizing it at the same time. And that's exactly what we're seeing here.
I know. And that was such a dirty dive kick, if you guys remember that Oki. He crossed him up and then him from the other side on the ground.
Exactly. And if you guys didn't tune in last Friday for cross-counter, I mean, a lot of the stuff that just happened in this match was exactly what Julio had talked about in terms of like how to play as Yun and how to beat Yun. So if you guys haven't checked that out, I don't even know if it's on YouTube or whatever, but if it's available on YouTube, you guys should check that out. This is you'll see a lot of really minute things that will help you with the matchup.
Absolutely. Cross-counter play has some great content just to help you learn the game and doing some very character-specific knowledge, which is what you need.
MMG Julio got the corner. Ooh, nice DP by Kenzo.
You know what? Kenzo is bringing it down to very small life leads, every single one of these games.
Yeah, he is. He's not getting beat hard. He is getting outplayed.
Absolutely. But, you know, he's showing he can still take these aggressive off. He's still making the damage happen.
He is making it happen, and that's the impressive thing about Kenzo. I'm a fairly inexperienced player, but has really good fundamentals, and he can actually come back because of just that reason alone.
And I think the hard thing is, you know, playing against someone like Yun, he's getting down to these low life totals, and then, you know.
Oh, that overhead. That was so early.
It really is.
And a player like Julio is just going to react to that. He can see that.
Mm-hmm. But I was saying, you know, he's getting down to these low life totals. But, you know, Yun just has greatest, you know, finishing potential. He deals so much damage in one burst at the end.
Yeah, yeah. So even though he lost that last round or just every round so far, he hasn't been completely out of the game. He's been keeping up, just can't close it out. And again, it's still a close round. He's getting some terrific reads with those fierce DPs.
Oh, amazing. I don't think he's missed a single one yet.
Mm-hmm.
All right. But he still played this whole game from the corner.
That's it. That should be it.
Yep. Maximum damage going straight into the ultra and then finishes it with the super.
Yeah, good stuff. Yeah, Julio takes it 4 rounds to none. Not a single round given up, but those